Valve is building a brand new headset, and it's not just an Index 2. Today we're going to be talking about the Deckard, a standalone hybrid headset with inside-out tracking. It's been 1,599 days since the first Deckard leak has appeared. And now, moving forward to 2025, it looks like we're finally closing in on a release date. I have covered the Deckard extensively here on the channel, from controller leaks, hardware prototypes, to Linux drivers, to SteamOS code, and even accessories. But in this video, we will be discussing everything we know about the Deckard so far. So what actually is the Steam Deckard? Deckard is the code name, which is likely a nod to Blade Runner's Rick Deckard, and this is backed by the controller leaks codenamed Roy, also Roy Batty from Blade Runner. The continuation of Valve's sci-fi naming references is so prevalent in this project, similar to what we saw with the Steam Deck and the Index. But Deckard is not just a sequel to the Index. It's its own standalone hybrid VR headset. The goal for this device, allowing a standalone VR experience completely untethered. So people who don't own a powerful PC will be able to put on their headset and play Steam VR games without tethering to a PC. Similar to what we saw with the Steam Deck, how it was a portable version of Steam. But this device will still be a hybrid, so it will have capability to run standalone. You'd also be able to connect to a PC to boost performance via a tethered connection or through Wi-Fi 6E, hopefully 7. Normally a sponsored segment would go right here, but I want to take the time to ask you that if you do enjoy today's video, please consider subscribing and liking. This week I'll be testing a brand new haptic VR vest for a video, and I can't wait for you all to see it. Before we get into the meat and bones of Deckard, we need to discuss the timeline of all the leaks. In January 2021, the first codenames of Deckard was found in strings within the Steam's VR code. And then in September 2021, ARS Technica confirmed to us that Valve is officially working on a next-gen VR headset. Then it went dark, super quiet, nothing for nearly 3 years. That was until November last year, when the controller leaks started appearing for Roy. These were found in code, then again 5 months passed all the way to March 2025, where we finally got to see leaks on the EV2 specifications and wireless USB dongle connectivity. Then in April 2025, Valve imports gasket manufacturing tools, hinting that production has already begun. Then in May 2025, we have EV3 prototypes found, Linux Steam VR driver updates, and ARM container tools. But that's not all. Just this week, a huge new leak came from inside the XR industry itself. Stan Larocque, the CEO of Lynx, company that's building their own standalone VR headset, confirms that he's actually seen the design for the Valve Deckard. He called it quite amazing and are sharing the same suppliers for components. He's not under an NDA, which means this is not speculation. This is the first time on record that someone has openly acknowledged Deckard's design is real and it's progressing. Expected to enter mass production in 2026, which is slightly later than the other leaks that we've heard at the end of 2025. But that release date could be for dev kit launches. But regardless, this is 100% one of the most confident confirmations that we've ever received. And the fact this is even coming to light means that the Deckard is just as close to becoming a real product as we thought. So now it's time to talk about the specs. And we need to be clear that the specs we're about to discuss have been found in prototype versions from early development. And Steam has a record of changing tech before actual release, so things are subject to change, but these are the specs confirmed in earlier prototypes, giving a rough estimate of what to expect. Firstly, the displays, 2160 by 2160, per eye, that's LCD panels at 120Hz. Now, on the comments of my last couple videos, people really expressed their concerns for it being LCD screens. Now, this could just be for the mock-up devices. They could actually go with micro OLEDs, but we will have to see on release. In terms of the chipset, it's likely going to be running the Snapdragon XR2 Gen 2 that we see in all the other devices like the Quest and the Pico, or the third generation. However, in the previous video, there was leaks announced that they are going to be including the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3, which is 25% faster, 25% more efficient, and more AI capable than the current standalone devices on the market right now. Eye tracking is very likely to be in here. From the leaks confirmed, gaze input referencing, very similar to what we've seen with the Apple Vision Pro, where you can control menus with your eyes. Of course, it will have inside-out tracking, meaning no base stations are required. There will be Lighthouse support via a dual tracking mode. The OS will be running the new SteamOS, which will be highly optimized for VR, similar to how they optimize SteamOS for the Steam Deck. In terms of streaming, it's supposed to have Wi-Fi 6/6E for wireless PCVR, which is very good low latency. But we also got leaks on the Steam USB dongle previously. You could plug this dongle into your PC and be able to stream it wirelessly at very low latency. Right now, we're unsure about FOV, horizontal and vertical degrees, or other various things about the device. But from what we do know, this will give us the best of both worlds in terms of a standalone device and being PC capable. This will be fantastic for getting people into the VR space who don't have the money to splash out on crazy spec computers, but still want to try some Steam VR games like Half-Life Alyx. Comparing it to other standalone devices on the market from Meta, Apple, HTC, Pico, this seems to be falling in line. The one thing that the majority of standalone devices struggle with is delivering performance without draining too much battery life, which is why you see so many devices only having 2 hours of battery. We can guesstimate that the battery life is going to be roughly the same, but we don't know if the accessories are swappable or you can have external batteries or if they've doubled up on the battery percentage. All of this right now is unknown, but I'm checking out the leaks every single day, so I'll make sure to keep you updated as soon as I get more info. So let's talk about the Roy controllers. This is where things start to get very interesting. So of course, like most companies going into standalone in the modern age, we're losing the ring. So the Roy controllers will be ringless and feature a gamepad layout. It will include A, B, X, and Y buttons, D-pad, triggers, and bumpers. This is not only designed just for VR gaming, but this will be designed for normal 2D flat screen gaming in VR. So if you're actually combining this with a virtual desktop, that technically makes Deckard a wearable Steam Deck, where you can play Steam games directly on a giant screen. Leaked CADs and the Steam VR string data suggest that these controllers are already being tooled for production. Now, the price of the Deckard is estimated to be $1,200. Now, this could be bundled with new in-house games, meaning we could get another Half-Life game or more Steam VR games in production, or even just a Steam voucher. It's likely that they're gonna bundle in some games or some sort of motive to make people want to buy the headset. Now, like most tech on the market, especially when it comes to Valve's track record, it's likely that this device is gonna be sold at a loss. The reason companies do this is to fuel the ecosystem, meaning people will spend money inside Steam. Steam will make more money by getting people into the ecosystem and buying games through them directly. So now we need to talk about the release date. When can we expect to see the Deckard on shelves? All the leaks that we've received so far are suggesting that we could see Deckard on shelves as soon as November 2025. If that's the case, then we should be seeing some announcements and trailers and more information coming out about these devices over the summer holidays. However, the dates that we've heard about that contradict what we discussed earlier about Stan Larocque, the CEO of Lynx, saying that it could be entering mass production in 2026. This could mean that dev kits could be arriving by the end of this year, or maybe it will be released in 2025. The thing that matters the most is that they're working on it and we have a rough time schedule between the end of this year and the beginning of next year. Steam will delay the production if they feel the device isn't ready to push out. The XR space is going to be super stacked. In 2026 alone, we're expecting Meta's next-gen headsets, codenamed Pismo Low and High, a potential Quest Pro 2 arriving in 2027, Samsung's Project Mohan launching in late 2025 with full Android app support, and then of course whatever Apple is cooking with the Apple Vision Pro 2 or Lite version. But here's the catch, Valve is not trying to win everybody over with a flashy, overbuilt, spec'd product. They're trying to carve their own space by focusing on things like true PC VR flexibility, custom version of SteamOS, appealing to power users and modders, then of course launching their own titles. This device is supposed to be the one that bridges between PCVR and Standalone itself. Subscribe for more VR news, that's everything we know about the Deckard right now, but let me know in the comments, will you be buying the Deckard on release? I hope you have a fantastic day, peace.